Baumeyer's acting as though something terrible is on his mind. He's suspicious of everything.
He's even afraid to use a phone. Yesterday he was doubling back trying to discover if he was being tailed.
Miller, it'd be a long shot. But if you can convince Baumeyer that these credentials are not forged and came straight from Germany, we'll be in on something hot.
Let's see that stuff.
Let me speak to the proprietor.
Yes, sir.
Yes, what can I do for you?
You're Mr. Baumeyer?
Yes.
I bring you greetings from Ranshaw.
How is he? Excuse me.
Hope you'll have some word for me tomorrow.
We will see.
Hey, Gates.
Fine, fine.
Here's Eppa's feeling mild.
Ah, that's wonderful.
Haben Sie gut geschlafen?
Once inside Baumeyer's establishment, Miller was in a position to pick up what evidence he needed. Important hall were rolls of microfilm, containing secret information destined for Germany, together with various informative documents.
Miller's now convinced that one of the Nazis Baumeyer's hiding has been told how to contact a big espionage group.
Where?
That's what we'd like to know.
Scott, just as soon as we find out the time and location of the rendezvous, we'll grab the prisoner.
Yes, sir.
Hello? Just a minute, please. Mr. Baumeyer. Yes? Immediately.
I don't want somebody now.
Officer, pile it up.
Thank you.
in. Stand up there now.
Any tables back here? It's full out front.
Mr. Baumeyer.
No! We're federal officers. Everyone remain seated.
Come on. Hurry up. Come on out of there, you. Hurry up.
All right, get in here. Come on.
With the arrest of August Baumeyer, and with the roundup under similar circumstances of hundreds like him, with a seizure across the country of vast quantities of firearms, ammunition, and high explosives, the Federal Bureau of Investigation achieved the destruction of the spy ring Adolf Hitler had intended to be one of his potent weapons in paralyzing American democracy. Today, the men of the FBI, whose activities extend out from Washington to the remotest corners of the land, are playing as vital a part in the nation's battle against crime as they played in the greater war against the armed forces of the Axis. Out of this war, the Federal Bureau of Investigation has emerged better equipped than ever to take the lead in coping with the lawless forces undermining the nation's internal peace and security. Through its policy of working in cooperation with local police, the FBI, under its able director, is helping to raise the standards of law enforcement everywhere to meet the challenge of the post-war crime wave. And in the task of leadership that lies ahead of them, the men of the FBI are determined that they shall continue to be known by their motto, fidelity, bravery, integrity.